Well, howdy folks, Yeehaw Fingy here, and I'm fixing to learn you some knowledge about my plugin PinIt. Now these instructifications are going to be for version 2. If you're still using version 1, you best mosey on over to the link in the description and get yourself all up to date and such. Also, this here vidge is for all you gunslingers looking to wrangle them in-game features. But for the nitty-gritty details on how to set up camp, I reckon you ought to rustle through to the readme on good old GitHub. Anyways, we best hit the trail before the sun sets and the tumbleweeds start a-rollin' through. Now let's talk about these here pins. A pin ain't just something you stick in your hat, it's a mark on the map, and that's a fact. It's got 6 parts to it, like a good old six-shooter. A name, a tag, a world name, and them X, Y, and Z coordinates. The name of a pin is plain as day. Bastion or Guardian Farm. Just keep it under 24 characters. No need for fancy frills. Spaces are fair game though. Now the tag, that's like branding your cattle. Helps you sort them out later on. Keep it under 16 characters and no spaces allowed. Short and sweet. Time to mark them locations with some pins. You got 2 tools in your holster, the quick draw slash pin it and the more intricate slash make pin. Slash pin it is like a light and fast draw at high noon. Stand where you want to drop that pin, holler slash pin it and slap on a tag and a name. If your name's got a space or two in it, wrap it up tight in them quotation marks. On the other hand, slash make pin is for when you're fixing to mark a spot from a distance. You need to give it 6 things: the world name, the X, Y, and Z coordinates, a tag, and a name. Don't worry though, the tab completes will help you fill things in right quick. If you're one of the sheriffs in town, you can wrangle server pins the same way, but with slash server pin it and slash make server pin. Whether you're quick on the draw or taking your time, remember the rules. Wrap them names in quotes if they've got spaces. Alright now, trailblazers, let's talk about where them pins wander off to after you've roped them in. It's all about them pin lists. As a Lone Ranger, you got 2 lists on your hands, the personal pin list and the server pin list. Your personal list is like a diary. Only you can peek inside and tweak them pins. The server list though, that's like a town bulletin board. Everyone can see those pins, but only the town officials can mess with them. Now, ready your ears for the slash pin list command. This beauty can be broad or narrow, like a canyon or a creek. Run slash pin list on its own, and you're looking at your personal pin stash. Every pin's got 2 buttons, the X for deleting it and the arrow for dispatching it to a friend. When you hit the delete button, you'll see a command for slash delete pin and a number pop up. But don't fret over it. Just hit enter if you want to say adios to that pin. I just wanted to make certain you were certain. No turning back from here. Same deal with the share button. You'll see slash share pin and a number, but you'll have to add your friend's name to the end. Next, you can hover over them pin names to spy on the tags you gave them, but we'll come back to that. If you're granted warp powers, that green bit on the pin will whisk you away faster than a prairie breeze. Now it's time to dig a little deeper into the pin list command. This here command ain't just a one-trick pony, it's got some moves up its sleeve. First off, you can toss up to 3 arguments at it. The first one's a chooser, server, or me. Slash pin list me is the same as plain old slash pin list, giving you a peek at your personal pins. But if you holler slash pin list server, you're eyeballing the grand old server pin list. On that server pin list, you won't find the delete button, unless you're the chosen sheriff in town. Instead, there's a little plus. Click that and you're rustling up that pin to add to your personal stash. The slash make pin command will show up with the particulars and all you gotta do is sling a tag and a name on it. Now let's dive a little deeper into the pin list command and add a couple more tools to your saddlebag. The second and third arguments are your trusty filters, like sifting gold from the river. First off, the world filter. It's got all the worlds lined up for you. Throw in an at all to see pins from every nook and cranny, or slap an at local to stick with the world you're already standing in. Next, you've got the tag filter. It's got a fancy autofill feature showing all them tags that were used in your chosen list. Now let's rustle up some examples. /pinlist me @local. This shows your personal pins in the world you're strutting in. /pinlist server @allfarm. This one shows you the pins on the server pin list with the tag farm from every world. If you're eyeballing a pin list with more entries than a saloon on a Saturday night, look for that arrow at the bottom. It'll guide you to the next page. But how about when you're trying to track down a specific pin, like a hawk circling its prey? Look no further than /findpin. Throw in /findpin with a search term and watch as it rustles up all them pins that match that there term. For instance, if you're hankering for some skeletal loot, try /findpin skeleton. It could dig up the server pins for a wither skeleton farm, a regular old bones farm, and even that personal pin for the skeleton horse you lassoed out yonder in the wild last week. Here comes the last piece of the puzzle, /deathpin. When the chips are down and you find yourself 6 feet under, this command is your lifeline. When the Reaper comes a-knockin' and you shuffle off this mortal coil, you'll get a message with a pin for the very spot you met your maker. If you're feeling uneasy on your way back to reclaim your belongings from the clutches of the afterlife, throw out a /deathpin at any time. It'll bring up that most recent death pin like a beacon in the dark. Remember though, it's a one-trick pony, only showing the latest spot you've perished. But don't fret, you can rope in that death pin just like you would a server pin. Look for that plus button and give it a click. Then that pin will be riding shotgun in your list, ready to guide you back to the scene of your demise. For the benevolent sheriffs in town, you can add a player name after /deathpin to get that player's death pin, in case someone perishes while they're away from keyboard and such. Thanks, Yeehaw Fingy. I'll take it from here. Well, there you have it. You're now a PinIt expert. I hope it's useful for you. If you'd like to keep up with my work, you can check out my website at fg83.net. I'm also on Twitch and Twitter as FingerGuns83. And of course, you can subscribe to this YouTube channel. I don't do socials often, but I always post when new things are around the corner. Thanks for stopping by. I'll see you next time.